Hello, I'm Steve with Touch of the Master's Hand, Holy Spirit Ministries. I wanted to talk today about some scripture, one scripture that the Lord kind of highlighted, and it's kind of how I deal with me about it. But anyhow, I'm going to kind of dive right into it. But 1 Corinthians 2 and 9. But as it is written, eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, nor have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who love Him. You know, the Lord deals with me in a lot of visions. It's just one of the gifts He's given me. So I'll give you an awesome book that the Lord inspired me to write. Just email me, steveyoungstrom@yahoo.com, and I'll send you a copy. But lately, He's been dealing with me in dreams. And a couple months ago, I had this dream. It was awesome. It was from God. 2 days later, He told me He highlighted that scripture. And I just, you know, my memory is not that great. I mean, I don't can't quote the Bible like I need to. I know it, not all of it. But so when the Lord tells me scriptures, because He does it all the time, I have to go look them up. I have no idea what they are, what they say. And it was exactly fit the dream. I'm not going to share the dream with you. I might later on. But what's God showing you? What's He teaching you? Kind of look at some of my other messages. Use what you got. You know what? I mean, my wife and I last week, we went to, the Lord dealt with me in November of last year, to go to Normal, Illinois. I want to go to Normal, Illinois. I live in Dallas, and it's, you know, 800-900 miles away, and what's up there, you know? I had to Google it, and it's like, why would I want to go there, you know? The kids live on the Pacific Beach in San Diego, really cool, awesome, you know, I'd rather go there and visit them, and, you know, enjoy that. Why couldn't it be Honolulu, Hawaii, or, you know, cruise to Alaska, or some cool destination spot, you know? Go to India and revival, you know, Normal, Illinois, but so we went. So, long story, this kind of goes along with the scripture, though. Eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, nor have entered into the hearts of man the things which God has prepared for those who love Him. So anyhow, this trip, He highlighted several things. You know, one of them was Normal, Illinois. He told me he was going to go spend 3 days to drive there and 3 days back, and it wasn't going to be a normal day. He highlighted this town called Idlewood. So I looked it up. Idlewood's not even, it's a town, has a zip code, but it doesn't really, that's it. I mean, it's like township. So, and then He highlighted nursing homes. He said, I want you to go to nursing homes. So I was like, okay, so I look it up. Nursing homes come up in this town called Mount Vernon, Illinois. So, but nothing in Idlewood. So, okay, God, so, you know, we're going to go. So we get in the car and go. Well, tell you the beginning of the journey and the end of the journey, but it was just God's stories all along the way, just orchestrated of who we met, where we stayed, the direction we went, and everything. So, told me, He said, I want you to go by way of Stillwater, Oklahoma. First, and then up through Missouri and then to Illinois. I'm like, okay. So I'll look it up. Stillwater, of course. Stillwater, figured Stillwater existed, but look it up. Okay. So I tell my wife, I said, we're supposed to go to Stillwater, Oklahoma first. I'm like, okay, God. So we're on our way up there. We're going through Oklahoma City, and, you know, we're driving 70 miles an hour, and my wife looks up, and there's a big sign. It says, Jesus House. It's a homeless ministry. Well, that's what my wife and I do down here. We minister every Sunday night at a homeless shelter in downtown Dallas. Have the whole service. So it's part of our heart. So anyhow, I'm going to make this, you know, 10 minutes. I'm going to make this kind of a brief video. I'll try to hurry up. So it's like, okay, so that's part of our journey. You know, that's one of the things that God did. So I'm still processing, highlighting, focusing, studying, praying. I don't know how that's how that's going to interact with what we're doing, but there's something there. So, okay, God, that's a sign. Okay, so we get to Stillwater, and nothing really happened. We get a hotel, and, you know, where we stay, and that was what the Lord dealt with me. So it's not that so much the destination as it is the direction I'm getting. So I'm like, okay, the eyes have not seen, so okay, I hadn't seen it. So the next day, get up about 5:30 early in the morning, I'm like, I want to go pray. I want to go, you know, I love that. Three cups of coffee, that's kind of, I mean, I just love that three cups of coffee. It's just me in the morning, and pray. So wake up, try to be quietly, not wake up my wife, and had all my stuff ready from the night before, and, you know, she's waking up just as I'm leaving, and so it's like, and she loves her prayer time too, so it's like, okay, so it's perfect. So I go outside, and I sit on this bench outside, and I'm praying, and I'm like, hadn't even finished my first cup of coffee, and I'm like, well, Lord, you sent me here. For what? Here I am, Stillwater, Oklahoma. I don't know anybody up here. It's like, here I am. So why, God? What's the purpose? Why am I here? Well, this guy walks out. He's 150 feet away, quite a ways away. Walks up the main door because I was kind of off the beaten, off the side. Starts smoking a cigarette. All of a sudden, he looks over at me and he just walks over to me. Well, his story was how he lost a son. He was 40 years old. He was a minister, youth minister, and it just tore him up. He said if it wasn't for his faith in God, you know, he'd make it. It was a ministering opportunity. Got to minister to him for a while, and then all of a sudden his cousin comes out, and then his aunt comes out because they were on like some kind of family reunion. An hour ministered to all of them. This lady sat down next to me and said, great day to praise the Lord. Absolutely, sure it is. You know, so I was like, okay, God, I see that. Well, then this Pentecostal old man who was a porter there, and he worked there, so he comes by with a trash can right in front of me to minister to him. So I'm like, okay, God, there's four people that I got to interject the gospel of Jesus into their lives. That's who I am. So, okay, God, I get it, I see it. So that's the beginning of the journey, and it was just like orchestrated everywhere we went, you know. I think I got time to tell this real brief story. Yeah, it might be about 12 minutes long, so sorry. So, we go to Mount Vernon, to Illinois. We went to Branson first and really, you know, it was just kind of there. I'm not exactly sure why yet, but we get to Mount Vernon, spend the night, and the Lord had highlighted nursing homes. Well, we go to three nursing homes the next day, and we ministered to a lot of different people, and several of them were highlighted. One old man was highlighted and just broke down and cried. He just lost his wife to cancer, quit believing in Jesus, and it was awesome. So, tell them we'll get them a Bible, and we come back, go back the next day, and there were some other people that the Lord highlighted. We went back, and my wife was like, we're supposed to spend another day in Mount Vernon. So, I'm like, okay, so, all right. So, we do. You know, that's, I was just being led by the Spirit. It was like, on a journey, but what do you want, God? Where do you want us to be? Places, you know, we're just those vessels. I just want to be that vessel for meat for the master's use. So we stay another day. My wife said, you know, she's having some awesome prayer by herself. She loved it because she doesn't get a lot of that down here in Dallas. Some, but not as much as she would like. And it was just awesome. So it was awesome for both of us. So I'm same thing. Got up about 5:30, went down and had my special spot in the Drury Inn, prayed. Prayed for the inn, prayed for the people there, prayed for prayer, for what God had highlighted for us. Well, and there was a computer there, a business center or whatever, so okay, look up ministries, found a couple ministries, and there was a Christian thrift shop. And the Lord said, I want you to go there. Like, okay, God. So, all right. So, we go there. on our way, we were leaving that day, and we were like, okay, God. So we go to the thrift shop. And we end up spending another night at the Drury Inn. But we go to the thrift shop, so we're thinking we're going to leave, and we're not. But so we go to the thrift shop, and my wife buys a bunch of stuff for the grandkids, you know, some cool stuff. And I'm like, okay, well, shit, you know, we can go to thrift shops in Dallas, but maybe that's what we're supposed to do. So, okay, I'm in. I don't know where your plans are. Direction you're going, but here we are. So we walk out the door, and we're walking by a car, and we're almost to the car. I'm almost to the car door, and a couple guys almost run into us. A couple older guys got to talking, ministering to them, talking about God, and they go where they go to church, and they listen to some of the same preachers we listen to, and same ministries, and just kind of was a connection. So we just talking about God. Well, one of the men, his dad was in this nursing home called, I forget the name of it. But he was in one of the nursing homes where we went to. And then his wife worked at this other one called Harvest Hills, where we ministered to several people. And one God really touched, who he gave a Bible to. And we needed to go back and see him. And his wife was the activities director there, interjecting Jesus into these people. What is the opportunity and chances of us randomly spending another night running into these people at a thrift store, and he's the husband of one of the ladies that works there, where the nursing home where God highlighted and told us to go to. And when we ministered, I ministered to a guy named Dave, and he was dying. I mean, he had cancer really bad. He was on his last at the end. My wife ministered to a guy named Clyde, and that was the one that broke down and recommitted his life to Jesus. So we decide to stay another night. We go back the next morning to talk to Clyde and to Lori, and we run into both of them. And Clyde was just like, the day before, a couple days before when I saw him, he was just dark, like dark, dark looking, mad, angry. He was just brilliantly shining with the glory of God. So we ministered to them, then we moved on. And that was the whole trip. It was like just orchestrated everywhere we went. I'd take too long to explain it all to you or to tell you all about it, but there was just time after time after time again. So the Lord kept dealing with me. He said, He's giving me, highlighting different cities. So he highlights Little Rock, Arkansas. I'm like, okay, Little Rock, Arkansas. So I tell my wife, I said, well, this was on the way back home. So I was like, we went to Normal, Illinois, and awesome stuff happened there. And just, but, so I was like, you know, we're on our way back home, and we're heading towards the little, and I said, well, maybe we're supposed to go down through Arkansas. So we go down through Arkansas instead of Oklahoma on the way home. So we're heading to Little Rock, and we get to Little Rock, and I'm like, I didn't feel anything. I just was kind of like, okay, God, maybe this, you know, you said it's a direction more than a destination. So, okay, so we're in Arkansas. So we're, you know, Texarkana border. We're going to spend the night there. My wife gets a hotel and everything, and 7:30, 8 o'clock, almost 8 o'clock at night, and she's like, well, it's only a couple more hours to Dallas, and we might as well just, you know, I'd already been driving all day. I was kind of tired. She's like, I'll just drive, and we'll just drive home. Doesn't make any sense. I'm like, okay, so we canceled the hotel. So, okay, fine. So I pull over at the next gas station, and so, you know, she takes over to driving. Well, my wife already has gotten two speeding tickets in the last 2 years, taken defensive driving twice. So I'm like, she's doesn't slow down. So I'm like, it's a 2.5 hour drive home, and she's like, I'll get us there in an hour and a half. I'm like, yeah, speed. I don't want you to speed. I don't want you to get a ticket. I don't want to raise her insurance. I was, you know, arguing with her. Like, So I look over, and she's going 90. In a 75 mile zone. slow down a little bit. Look over, she's going 100. I'm like, honey, you're going 100. No. I'm like, I'm looking right at the speedometer. She's like, okay, I'll slow down. Finally, I got tired of arguing with her, and I said, well, God, I said, I'm just going to go to sleep, and it's in your hands. She's being hard-headed, and so I'm like, this journey's been where you wanted us to be, and, you know, I'm just going to go to sleep and rest, and, you know, we're heading back home. So we're about 60 miles outside of Dallas, and plus my wife wakes me up, honey, I'm getting pulled over. What? I told you not to speed, blah, blah, blah. I started giving her a hard time and harassing her and raising her insurance and blah, blah, blah. And I'm fussing at her and she's like, sorry, I'm trying not to speed, blah, 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 blah. We get pulled over as a young cop, county sheriff. Ma'am, you know why I pulled you over? Anyhow, starts lecturing her and pulls up her license and tells her, you know, you had two defensive driving things on your record. What was those for? And, you know, she told him one of them, they were for, you know, he found out they were for speeding, and just, so he's lecturing her, and he says, well, you know, where were you guys going, coming from, where are you coming from? And I told him, I said, you know, you may not believe it, but, you know, God told us to go to Normal, Illinois, we're ministers, and we just got in the car and went. We've been on a journey for 7 days, and he's like, so he lectures my wife some more, about 10 minutes probably, about speeding and stuff. And he said, you know what? He said, I'm a firm believer in Jesus Christ. He said, most troopers out here wouldn't care, wouldn't give a darn about your story. They'd just give you a ticket. He said, but I'm not going to give you a ticket because I'm a firm believer in Jesus Christ. And before the conversation was over with, I was like, well, you brought up Jesus, so here's my opportunity. So I ministered to this cop on the side of the highway at 11 o'clock at night. Came a copy of the book, the message that the Lord told me to bring with us, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. But basically, it's how God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit all live in you. Scriptures to back it up, about 15 scriptures, maybe even 20. Send you a copy of that if you want to. Just email me. At steveyoungstrom@yahoo.com, and send a copy of the book, the message, you know, want us for an offering, send you junk mail, nothing. That's it. Just those two things. But, so I got a chance to minister to this cop on the side of the highway, so what should have been a ticket, because most police officers aren't going to cut you that kind of slack. I mean, that's just who they are. It's, you know, it's not, you know, nobody likes to get tickets, but that's what cops do. So, opportunity, what looked like one way, completely turned another way. So that's the part about the eyes have not seen, nor ears have heard, nor entered into man the thing which God has prepared for those who love Him. So, here's what you got. I don't know what God's showing you, teaching you, telling you, direction He wants you to go. You know, email me, comment on this channel, share it with others. You know, all I'm trying to do is get out the gospel of Jesus Christ, and because of the dispensation of time we're in, and that's the message of the hour. We're in a grace dispensation. Could judgment happen? Could the switch could get flipped tonight? Just, you know, look at some of my other messages, but I'm not going to preach the hellfire and brimstone message. I've been in a Pentecostal movement for 10 years, the holiness movement for 7. It's just a, you know, it's just a journey that's God taking me on. He said, plow down the center. You know, right now we're in a grace dispensation. Just look at some of my other messages. Look at the one about the economic collapse of the USA. You know, tell you all about the grace that we're living in. It's a time for us to reach souls and to get out the gospel. And I'm going to put a plug in for a friend of ours, Braveheart Ministries, Peter Lewis. Look him up. Awesome message. There's a lot of good ministries out there that are preaching this message. And it's about Jesus. I'm going to end with this. You know, we think we're such a great, awesome country because we put in God We Trust on a dollar bill. Some kind of weird pyramid on there with an eyeball. some sayings that I don't even know what they say, pluribus unum or whatever, Some people say the Statue of Liberty is like a Greek goddess or whatever. It kind of does look like a goddess. It's weird looking, you know? So, I mean, go tell Congress you want to put in Jesus We Trust on the dollar bill. See how far that gets you. Try to get a hold of President Trump and tell him that. Try to even tell that to the church. A lot of churches are like, oh, God, but Jesus is out of the equation. But Jesus was God's ultimate plan for man's salvation. So, anyhow, I'm not going to... That's a whole other message, and I don't want to be too lengthy, and I've already been too lengthy. I'm just going to help pray that people have listened to this, but to the end of this message. But, you know, just email me, steveyoungstrom@yahoo.com, copy of the free book, look at some of my videos, share them with other people. Thank you for tuning in. God bless you. Trying to limit these, but it's just really hard. There's so much that I want to share with y'all. Thank you. God bless you for tuning in. Have a great and wonderful and awesome day. Please comment. Please share these videos. Please look them up. Look up Braveheart Ministries, Peter Lewis. Awesome minister. Awesome evangelist. Thanks for tuning in. God bless you. Bye-bye.